Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about Boolean expressions. There are two purposes of Boolean expressions. One is it is used to compute the logical values, and another one is they are used as a conditional expressions in flow of control statements. So for example, if then else and while statements. So if E then statement. So this E, this expression is a Boolean expression. So in conditional expression, in flow of control statements, Boolean expressions are used as conditional expression because the result is true or false. Boolean expressions can have two Boolean values, true and false. So if E then S1 else S2. So here also the conditional expression is a Boolean expression. If this expression is true, S1 will be evaluated, otherwise S2 will be evaluated. While E do yes. So in these flow of control statements, Boolean expressions are used as conditional statements, and it is also used for computing the logical expressions. And Boolean expressions are formed with the help of three Boolean operators: and, or, not. So these are the Boolean operators used for composing the Boolean expressions. Here, and or are the left associative, and not is a right associative operator. And not is having highest precedence than other highest precedence out of all the three. And is a next higher precedence. Or is in the lowest precedence level. Then we should know about translation scheme for Boolean expressions, that is how to translate the Boolean expressions into three address code. Here there are two methods for translating Boolean expressions into three address code. Translating Boolean expressions has two types. One is numerical representation, another one is flow of control method. So this is otherwise called as short circuit method. So numerical representation means here the true is considered as 1, the numerical value 1 is assigned to true, and false represent 0. In the flow of control, in this video we are going to discuss about only numerical representation, but flow of control or short circuit code means, suppose if you want to evaluate A or B, means we can say, suppose here we can say that if A is true, we can say that the entire expression is true. There is no need to evaluate B, right? Similarly in AND, if A is false, then we can say that the entire expression is false. But if A is true, we need to evaluate B. So this is called as short circuit code. We will discuss about short circuit code in the next videos. So in this video, we are going to discuss about numerical representation. So consider the first example, A or B and not C. This Boolean expression is composed of Boolean operators AND, OR and NOT. So how the three address code will be evaluated from this? The first higher precedence is given for NOT. So NOT C will be evaluated first. So to store this result, we need a temporary variable T1. So T1 is NOT C. Then we need to evaluate B and this result. So T2 is equal to B and not C is evaluated in stored in T1. So T2 is B and T1. Finally, we need to perform OR operation. So T3 is equal to A OR T2. So this is the sequence of three address statements for example 1. Next, consider A less than B, a relational expression A less than B. So this is equivalent to if A less than B, then 1, else 0. So this relational expression is equivalent to the conditional statement, if A less than B, then 1 else 0. So now we can construct the three address statement for this example. So to construct three address statement, we are going to consider the indexes also. So assume that the first the index of the first statement is 100. So in the first statement, if A less than B, go to 103 will be performed. This is the general way of performing the conditional expression. So 100 in the first line, if A less than B, if the condition is true, then go to 103, that is the current place plus 3 will be performed. Then 101 means the statement, this expression is false, so that here t is equal to 0. So the temporary variable is assigned as 0 because the result is false. And after assigning 0 to t, go to should be performed. And since 103 is used for assigning 1 to t, here go to 104 should be performed, that is the current place plus 2. So these are the four three address statements for A less than B. So if A less than B, A is less than B, if you want to construct a three address statement, first we need to consider this conditional statement, if A less than B, then 1 else 0. So to construct three address statement, we need these four lines. So 100 is if A less than B, condition is true means go to 100 plus 3, that is 103. So in 103, 1 is assigned to T because the condition is true. Then the next statement will be executed. But if the condition is false means in the next statement, 0 is assigned to T. That is false. So t is equal to 0. After assigning 0 to t, we have to go to statement number 104. We should not evaluate this statement. So go to 104 should be performed. So here jump to third statement, here jump to second statement should be performed. So we will see about these operations in the syntax directed translation. So this is the grammar for Boolean expressions. E tends to E, R, E, E and E, not E, parenthesis to E. E may be a relational expression, ID, relational operator ID 2, and E may be simply true or false. So here we have used some functions. A new temp means it will return a new temporary variable. Emit. Emit is used for producing, this function is used for producing three address statement in output file. Then we have used next state here. Next stat. So next state means it gives the index of the three address statement. Next three address statement. So this emit increments next state after producing each three address statement. So now we will see the productions one by one. So E tends to E R E, E1 or E2 means to store the result we need a temporary variable. So this E dot place, the attribute place will have a new temporary variable. Then in output file, emit will produce the three address statement like E dot place is equal to E1 dot place or E2 dot place. Similarly, the same operation, the same semantic action will be performed for AND. So here AND should be used. Then E tends to not E1 means E dot place is new temp. Then this E dot place is equal to not E1 dot place. Then parenthesis to expression means E dot place is E1 dot place. Then for the relational expression, E dot place is equal to new temp. New temp will return a new temporary variable. Then we need, for the relational expression, we need four statements, right? So first statement is emit if id 1 dot place, relational operator. First we need to emit if A less than B. A means id 1 dot place, A less than B, right? Id 1 is A, relational operator id 2. So if id 1 dot place means A, relational operator is less than, id 2 dot place means b, then go to 103. Here the index of the statement is 100, so we have written 103 here. So here we need to perform jump to next state plus 3. Then t equals 0 should be performed. So this e dot place, this new temporary variable, is equal to 0, will be produced as output. Then the third statement is go to 104, that is next state plus 2. So go to next state plus 2 is a semantic action. Then finally t equals 1. T equals 1 means e dot place equals 1. So this is a semantic action for relational expression. Then e is simply true, means e dot place is new temp, then that new temp is equal to 1 should be assigned. Similarly for false, 0 is assigned. Now we will take one example, then we can construct a parse tree, and from the parse tree we can construct the three address statements. So consider this example. Now we have to construct the parse tree. So e is the start symbol of the grammar. We need or operator. So e tends to ERE. Then before R we need the relational expression. So E can be replaced by ID, relational operator ID. Then after this R we need AND expression. So this E can be expanded by using E AND E. And this E is in relational expression. So id, relational operator id, and this e is also a relational expression, id, relational operator id. Now we know the name of this identifier is a, and this relational operator is less than b, a less than b, or c less than d, and e less than f. So now we are going to construct the three address statement. So since these attributes are synthesis attribute, we are going to evaluate it from the bottom to top. So here there is a reduction. So id, relational operator id is reduced to e. Id, relational operator id is reduced to e. So we are going to generate the three address statements now. So e dot place is equal to new temp. So assume that t1, first temporary variable is t1. So e dot place is equal to t1 is assigned. So now in emit function will produce a three address statement. Assume that its starting index is 100. So if id 1 dot place means a, relational operator less than id 2 dot place b, go to next state plus 3. So 100 plus 3 is 103. So if a less than b, go to 103 will be produced. Then e dot place equal to 0. In the next index, e dot place is equal to 0. E dot place means t1. So t1 is equal to 0 will be produced. Then in the next statement, go to next state plus 2. So this number, this index plus 2. So 104 will be produced. Then emit of e dot place equal to 1. So 103 is e dot place is t1. So t1 is equal to 1. So we have produced the same three address statement here. If a less than b, go to 103, t temporary variable equal to 0, go to 104, temporary variable equal to 1. Then after reducing here, we need to go here, but here there is no reduction because e should be, we need the value for e. So now there is a reduction here. So id, relational operator id is reduced to e. So id, relational operator id. So again the same statement is performed. So e dot place is equal to new temp. So e dot place is t2 here. Then emit function, there are four emit functions. So next three address statement, next index is 104. Then it will produce if here id 1 dot place is c, relational operator is less than, id 2 dot place is d. Then go to next state plus 3. 104 plus 3 is 107. Then in the next index, e dot place equal to 0. E dot place means t2 T2 is equal to 0 is produced. Then go to next state plus 2. So 108, 106 plus 2 is 108. Then E dot place equal to 1. So T2 is equal to 1 is produced. Then after reducing here there is no reduction. Now there is a reduction here. So here next index is 108. So in 108 ID relation operator ID is reduced to E. So E dot place is equal to new temp. So T3. Then emit four emit functions. So if E less than F, go to next state plus 3. So 108 plus 3 is 111. Then 109. In this index, E dot place is 0. So T3 is equal to 0. Then go to next state plus 2. So 112. Then E dot place equal to 1. So T3 is equal to 1. So we have reduced this production here. So now after reducing this, E and E is reduced to E. So E and E is reduced to E. What is the semantic action here? E dot place equal to new temp. So this E dot place is equal to new temporary variable T4. Then the emit function will produce the three address statement. E dot place is equal to E1 dot place and E2 dot place. E dot place means T4. T4 is equal to T2 and T3. T4 is T2 and T3. Then we need to reduce ERE to E. So ERE is reduced to E means the semantic action is E dot place is equal to new temporary variable. So T5. Then this E dot place is equal to E1 dot place or E2 dot place. So T5 is equal to T1 or T4. T5 is equal to T1 or T4. So this is the semantic, the sequence of three address statements for the given expression A less than B or C less than D and E less than F. Thank you.